You're not working hard enough. It's a fact. Even people who think that they're working hard are not working hard enough. And that is why you are not getting where you want to go. You're depressed, you're sad, you're angry, you're jealous. All of these fears, all of these feelings manifest themselves because the fact of the matter is you are not putting enough effort in, you're not putting enough time in, you're not putting enough sweat and tears to push through to get what you want. I work every week with people who are not in business who want to be in business. There are people who have a dream of starting something, of developing a product, of getting financing, of launching their business. They are pre-revenue. They are pre-entrepreneur, if that's even a word. But they have the bug and they want to do something. And I question whether they have it, whether they will work hard enough. Because frankly, when you work for someone else, you may think you work hard, but you learn a whole new level of hard work when you work for yourself. And then I also work with successful people, people who are deeper into their career. They may still have the fire, they may still have the passion, but they're pretty darn comfortable. This is their second rodeo, their third time around, their fourth business. They're used to having team, they're used to having structure, they're used to having everything. Do they really want to work hard enough? Where you are in your business right now, ask yourself, are you working hard enough? Because I can tell you for myself, there are seasons when I know that I'm so overwhelmed that I'm having trouble keeping on top of things. And then there are times where I'm super, 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 super comfortable. And those times where I'm comfortable, when I'm letting things off the hook, I know that I'm not really working that hard. And my version of not that hard is like 50 or 60 hours a week. But it's not the hours, it's the mental commitment, it's the drive, it's the push, it's the hunger, it's the, am I willing to make a bold or hard decision? That's how I define hard work. Because you can work 80 hours in the week, but if you're just busy blowing off half of those, but you're still working or keeping busy, then you may think you're working hard, but you're not working hard. So how do we define this? How do we dig into this? How do you find out for yourself if you're working hard enough? I have a few things I want you to consider. The first is it's not just about the time. It's about effort and focus. If you are putting in all of the effort that you have available for it, if you're proud of your effort, if you're proud of yourself, whether you succeed or fail, whether you accomplish your task that day or not, if you're proud of what you're doing, then I would say that you're working pretty darn hard. And if you're not proud of it, then that is your heart, that is your soul, that is your gut telling you that you're not working hard enough because you yourself are not proud of the effort you're putting in. And focus. You can run top speed and put in all the effort and all of the grit in the world, but if you're going the wrong f-ing direction, then how does that help you? Second, don't look at others. Don't allow those people who question if you're working too hard to affect you, but also don't look at what other people are doing and say, oh, they're putting in 90 hours a week, I guess I should as well. Maybe 90 hours a week is correct. Maybe 60 hours a week is correct. I'm never gonna say 40 hours a week is correct. If you're working 30 or 40 hours per week, unless if you're trying to run some kind of passive income, that's not enough. Yes, you wanna maximize your time. You wanna be efficient with your time. You wanna be able to delegate, maybe get an EA, roll into one thing and roll into the next, of course. But if you're putting in 30 or 40 hours a week, do you honestly think that you're working hard enough? You may be stuck in the smart. I'm working smart and hard, right? Work harder. If your current workload and your current approach is not taking you to the place that you want to be, then you need to change what you're doing. The flip side of this is you need to surround yourself with like-minded or supportive people. If you have to put in 50 or 60 hours over the next month to make this project, this campaign, this product you're launching, if you need to put in the time to make this work, then you have to do it. And you need to surround yourself with people who understand that you have to do it and will give you the grace and the understanding and the love and the support to allow you to do it. If I'm having a really busy time in my business, I have to turn to my wife. I have four kids, you know, we've been married for 14 years. We have a pretty hectic, busy life. We have the dog, we got competitive dance, we have all of that stuff. But if I'm entering into a busy season, I need to turn to my wife and I say, the next 6 weeks are gonna be crazy, I'm sorry. They are. It means like I already get to work at 6. On Fridays, I put in 16-hour days to catch up. I work on weekends. I already do that stuff. I do that outside of my home life hours. I try to do it during the week. Last night I got home at my scheduled time. I had to make dinner. I had to be able to put it on the table. I had to do dishes. And guess what? I had 3 hours of work I had to do. And so my wife knows we're in a busy season. She may not like it, but she understands it. And she is willing to support me and allow me to do it. If she wasn't, if she was angry, if she was disappointed, if she felt hurt, if she felt like she was second best all of the time, then my relationship is going to fall apart, or I'm going to walk around with constant guilt. I will not commit to doing the work because in the back of my head, I'm going to second guess whether I can do it. If a client calls me up right now and says, "Hey, Mark, I need you to be here at 7 p.m. tomorrow night," I will say yes. And then I will turn to my wife and I will say, "I'm sorry, I need to be at work at 7 p.m. tomorrow night." And then she'll say, "Oh, but we have these plans. We have these things that we have to do." And now it's on me to find the babysitter, to figure things out, to apologize, to make it up for her, to figure something out. But I would never second guess whether I have to be there at 7 p.m. tomorrow night or not. I have to. I will put in the time. I will put in the effort. I will go there. I will do the work that I need to do. And so circling around on those friends and family who tell you you're working too hard, their number one worry is that you are going to burn out, that you are going to run ragged, and it's a very real risk. So what you have to ask yourself is, are you facing these moments right now? I can remember a time when the business was just me and three other people, and we were in a really, really, really busy season. I was working until 2 or 3 in the morning. I was getting up at 6 or 7, and I was doing it all over again, day after day after day, 6 or 7 days of the week for 3 or 4 weeks in a row just to make this project happen. And I was exhausted. And my son came up to me. I was sitting on the edge of the bed getting ready to go to work. And my son, who was maybe 3 or 4 at the time, said, "Daddy, oh my goodness." He was so excited to see me. He woke up. He's like, "Daddy, you're here." I said, "Hey, buddy, yeah, it's good to see you." And he was not only happy and surprised that I was there, but he was like, "Oh, this is so amazing. I love you. I miss you. I'm glad you're here." This is my son in my own home. He's saying this. And I started crying. And he said, "Why are you crying?" And it was because I was so tired. I was tired. I was exhausted. I have to go through and do this all over again. I have to leave. Is it worth it? Is it really worth it? I'm missing that moment. My kid is telling me that they're surprised that I'm even at home. I can't go back and change that. I know that I had to do that in order to make my business succeed through the recession. I know that I had a client in front of me who was willing to pay me to keep me in business. And so can I go back and be there those extra days for my 3 and 4 year old? I can't. Would I do it again? I would. I would do what I did again because I wouldn't be here without that sacrifice, without that hard work. If you find yourself continually stressed out, getting anxiety or depression, I'm not going to tell you to work harder. I'm going to tell you to look for the root cause as to what is causing this in your life. You need to find out what is leading to this and you need to fix it because you should be able to work at a consistent pace. I would challenge anyone whether they're working hard enough. And if you are running ragged, then maybe you are working hard enough, or maybe there's some part of your life that you need to fix. Maybe that's a side effect of something. I can tell you, when a client comes to us with a certain request, I'm the only person in the company who can do it, and I hate it. I'm good at it, but I hate it. I hate doing the work. I don't enjoy it. I don't like it. It's like pulling teeth. But guess what? I'm the only one in the company who's capable, and I'm really, really good at it despite the fact I hate it. So if I had to do that all the time, you better believe I'm going to really hate my life. I'm going to hate my company. I'm going to start to procrastinate. I'm not going to want to attack it. I'm not going to like it. If my wife didn't support me with that meeting I might have at 7 p.m. tomorrow afternoon, and every single time I ask for something, it's another fight. Gonna have to carry that with me all the time. Oh, here comes another fight. Here comes another fight. It's gonna have an effect on my relationship with her, or it's gonna make the business suffer. So if you find yourself stressed out all of the time, if you find yourself exhausted all of the time, if you think that you're running yourself ragged or more people are telling you you're working too hard, that's maybe a side effect. But absent of that, pick up the pace. Let's go. Let's work. Let's do this. Let's hustle. Sacrifice today for what you want tomorrow. And don't get impatient, and don't think you deserve it, and don't think because of your title, you know, that you've hit it because you're 12 months in or 2 years in or whatever it is. The people you look up to, your heroes, the people who have done it, have put in the years, they've put in the hours, and they've put in the time. So I challenge you to do the same thing. And like always, you have to think big, to be bold, you have to say yes. Thought that was hilarious. Ha ha ha.
If growing and scaling your business by being better at sales and better at marketing, better at customer experience is important to you, be sure to check out this video right over here. And like always, subscribe to my channel, click on the bell icon, and get each video every day when it drops.